There is a problem in Assam. It's called the NRC and it's a big one. If you haven't been following what's been happening, here's a lowdown on what the National Register for Citizens is and what the many problems around it are. The government is updating the National Register for Citizens in Assam from the existing 1951 version. The process began in 2015 under the State Congress government, but it has been high on the BJP's priority since the 2014 general election campaign.
This character of Assam was to be compromised with. This cultural character, this demographic character, and vote banks were to be imported from across the border.
Chahe Paschim Bengal ho, chahe Assam ho, Bangladeshiyon ki ghuspeth ke karan pareshan.
And it is a big issue in the state, but in the 6 decades since 1951, a lot has happened. A new country, Bangladesh, was formed. Many people moved in and out of Assam from neighboring states and Bangladesh too. So Assam has had this original inhabitants versus the illegal Bangladeshi Muslims battle for a long time.
Bangladesh se jo ghuspaithi aaye hain unko bahar bhejna chahiye ki nahi bhejna chahiye.
The NRC is meant to be a database to identify these illegal immigrants. But in a state that has a history of migration, many are finding it difficult to find the necessary documents. So how is the government deciding who is a citizen? Each applicant must establish a link to their parent, grandparent or an ancestor whose name exists in the 1951 NRC or in any of the electoral lists up to 1971. There are also a bunch of 12 documents issued before 71 that are acceptable. In the first draft, of the 3.9 crore that applied, 1.9 crore people were verified. The second draft verified 2.89 crore people. So naturally, the next question is, what happens to the 40 lakh people who've been left out? And this question is at the heart of a big debate.
इससे क्या होगा? बहुत से लोगों को डिलीट किया गया है. और इसमें ये भी है कि वो purposely डिलीट किया गया है. ये भी एक उसमें.
ठीक है. आप सहमत की बनो ना.
नहीं, एक मिनट, मैडम. अगर ऐसा हुआ, तो ये बहुत बड़ी गलती आप लोग कर रहे हैं. और फिर वहाँ पर एक बहुत बड़ा division aap karne ja rahe hain.
And the people are afraid that they will be deported or be sent to detention camps. The government of course has said that none of that will happen.
Higher administrative level par claims and objections ka disposal hoga. Pehle to ye main clarify karna chahta hu. Phir uske baad bhi koi santusht nahi hota hai to uske liye foreigners tribunal mein jane ka avsar rahega. Adhyaksh mahoday, aur main samajhta hu kahin na kahin to nyay milega hi.
But till it is actually resolved, the fate of 40 lakh people is hanging in the balance. And with less than a year left for the 2019 election, the government and the opposition are adamant on winning the argument.